Hey guys, Milan here, and today I'm going to teach you how to install mods properly in Euro Truck Simulator, and this is valid for American Truck Simulator as well. This video will guide you through all steps you need to do to install mods in both these games, and then I will go over some tips which might come handy for you. If this is the first time you are installing a mod, you have to check if you have the mod folder. This is where you're going to place all the mods you want to use. To check about the folder, you go to My Documents, Euro Truck folder, and if you don't see a mod folder, you create one. It has to be named mod exactly as you see in the video. First, you need to get mods. You have multiple places where you can get mods from. I recommend three places: ATS forum, Steam Workshop, and my YouTube channel. Also, there are good forums and websites to get mods, but sometimes we might encounter some problems. Pay attention to the mods description. So mods require some type of DLC. This happens very often in maps, but it may also happen when you download a tuning pack which requires you to have a tuning DLC in order for it to work. Pay also attention to which version of the game the mod was made. In this case, I'm running the 1.45 version of the game, and you can check the version you are in the bottom right corner of the main menu of the game. If for any reason you are running older versions of the game version should be in one of the corners in the main game menu. As I have the 1.45 version of the game, which is the latest stable version at the time I'm making this video, I should only be searching for mods made or updated for this version. Although it's possible for some mods to run on multiple versions of the game. It depends on the mod and on the game updates. You can download mods from Steam Workshop. By this way, you don't need the mod folder you created first, and all you have to do is search what you want, subscribe, and then activate the mod in-game. Also, in this method, when a mod gets updated, it automatically downloads the update for you, and you don't have to worry about it whatsoever. In-game, I recommend you to create a spare save to run mods, and have another main save without any mods you need to play multiplayer, for example. And in-game, you have to select the save where you want to use the mod. Click in the mod manager, and here you will find all the mods you subscribed, and then you activate the mod by moving it to the right list. Only the mods on the active list are the ones you are able to use in this game save. Not all mods are on Steam Workshop, and for that reason, you can download them from multiple places. You can download mods from my videos. All you have to do is choose the mod you want and consult the video description for the download link. Also, I do a series of videos about the best mods of each month for you to download. Link is in the description for those videos. When downloading mods from a website, please don't download executable mods. If someone says you have to install an executable, it's most likely a virus or a malware. To download a mod, you will probably use ShareMods website majority of time. There are some similar pages, but it's the same thing, and you proceed clicking download until you download the mod. Be careful with pop-up ads. The majority of time the PC antivirus will go off, but it's fine as long as you don't allow or click anything of it. Just close the pop-up ads and you're fine. When downloading mods, we might encounter three types of files. The first is a ATS file. All you have to do is move it to the mod folder. Then we might have a zip or a RAR file. When I download these type of files, I open them and see what they have inside. If I see a bunch of files and folders and mod description files with a dev folder as well, I close the RAR or the zip file and move it to the mod folder. If I see a ATS file or multiple ATS files inside a RAR or a zip, I move them to the mod folder. Some mods might be protected with a password. If that is the case, try moving the RAR or the zip file straight to the mod folder. If that doesn't work or doesn't show up in game, you might need the password of the file. In that case, the mod author should somehow have it in the description of the download page. This is something that rarely happens, but you might eventually find a situation like this. Activating the mod in game, it's the same process as installing the Steam Workshop mods. All mods you place in the mod folder will appear in the mod manager, and all you have to do is moving them to the list on the right side. Installing a map might be a bit different. Depending on the mod, it might only come one ATS file, and if that is the case, you just move the file to the mod folder. However, the majority of time you need to download the mapping parts. After downloaded, you will see a bunch of RAR or zip files ending in very similar names. When I see these, I extract them together. For this, I use 7-zip. You have to select all the parts, right mouse click, 7-zip, and then select this option. The way I do it, it makes a new folder containing the important files extracted. All you have to do is follow the same principle as stated before and drag all the extracted ATS files to the mod folder. After this operation, you have to activate the mod in-game. If you are installing mods for the first time, I advise you to create a spare save to run mods, especially maps. With some exceptions, for the maps, you will almost always need a new profile, unless it's some kind of add-on, but for that, you should be informed. I will detail more of this ahead in the video. To create a new save, you activate map mod first. Pay very close attention to the order of the parts of the map, usually it's set by the modder somehow. Fill up all the info like name, favorite track and so on, and you have to pay close attention to this. A lot of people fail to this and it's very simple. Sometimes maps requires you to change the module, and if you don't, that's why your game might not be loading the map. So that's it, here is a tip that will always help you regarding installing maps. The first step is to activate map in the mod manager, and then always watch the module. If this option becomes available, you change it to whatever it says. If it stays disabled, it's not needed. Now, if you have it disabled and the game keeps crashing when loading the map, for the first time, might be the load order, which might be wrong, or some file is missing, or the map could actually have a problem. Also very important, always pay attention to which version of the game the map was made. We are on the 145 at the time I'm making this video. The majority of 144 maps don't work on the 145. But there are 2 or 3 that do work, it really depends. At the time I'm making this video, I have to wait for the modders to update their map to match the version of the game. For the physics, the process of installing might require something different. The process of download is the same as stated in the previous topics, and installing too. What differs from the rest of the mods is that some physics mods requires you to change some values in save to turn it even more realistic. The first step is to identify which save you want to use the mod. You can go to the mod manager and then activate the physics mod. If you have plenty of saves like me, I recommend you to load up the save. After being loaded, you can either go back to the main menu of the game or leave the game. Next step is to go to My Documents, Euro Truck folder, and then you open the Profiles folder. Here, order it as date modified. Make sure the error is pointing down. By doing this, the last save you loaded up will be at the top. Now open the save folder and then you open the config sfg and config local files. I open them using notepad++, but you can use the default notepad which comes with the Windows, or even WordPad. Any text editor should be able to open it. From here you have to change the values of the items which the modder recommends. In this case I'm changing these values as required. After this you are ready to play with it. The mod manager list is really important. It's done in a way which the mods at the top of the list are more important than the ones in the bottom. Usually the physics mods have to be in top of them all. I don't have much experience with load order of types of mods, as I delete and create new saves quite often, and usually just throw them in there, but I don't recommend this. This way it might affect your gaming performance. When creating a new profile save, I advise you to not activate all mods at once. When you create a new save, create without any mods activated unless it's a map mod. In that case, you create a save only with the map activated. You play for a bit, 1 to 3 minutes, drive around for a bit and then you might activate some mods. Once you have some progression on the save, you can activate some mods at once. Not many, but for instance you might activate new truck, new trailer, new sound and graphic mods together. It's possible to mix maps together, but not all maps mix, and the main reason is that they have different scales. For this, you have other online guides and YouTubers which make videos regarding the subject. This also happens with some kind of mods. Usually tuning mods, you can use them all at the same time, but it's not possible for traffic mods, as they will most likely conflict. Regarding maps, let's say you created a profile using Promos map. If you are wondering what this is, it's basically the best modded map of Europe you can get in this game. But let's say you already have a save with it. And what happens when the game updates, you might ask? Do I need to build a save from zero? Well, once again, kinda depends. Usually, when the game updates, you will have to wait for the promos maps or other any map to be updated, in case it gets outdated with the game update. So, in case you need to update the map, you should delete the previous map files in mod folder and place there the new updated files. After that, take a look at the mod manager of the respective save, just to make sure you have the said map installed. Once verified or corrected, you should be able to load up the save without any problems and keep the progress and the grind on that save. Also, keep in mind that mods you download via third parties, such as all the options besides Steam Workshop, you will need to manually get the new updates. Once the mod gets released with a new update, you need to re-download the mod and replace the files in the mod folder. Using mods in multiplayer is possible, but wait, if we are talking about third-party multiplayer hosted by Truckers MP, very very few mods are usable there. If we are talking about Convoy Mode, which is the official multiplayer to play with our friends, you already have some options to choose from, but that is a topic for another time. So, I think that's it for now. Any questions, please comment down below and I'll try my best to help you. Also, let me know if you have any other topics about these games you want to know about. Thank you and have fun.